shoot first, and here goes Burton again, as if we haven't seen enough of him tonight like this.
How can he not go to the backhand? Now, when he goes to the forehand, if he goes to the forehand, what does he do? Does he try 3 for a quarter? He's 0 for 7 in his career.
Except he has one big penalty shot under his belt tonight. Here he comes, shoots it. Fleury stops him this time, as he did try to go to the glove. And Fleury denied him.
Well, he completely went away from his what had gave him success in this game, when that backhand to forehand move. And Marc-Andre Fleury, 1 for 1.
And now Letang will try his luck against Brian Elliott. Letang is 2 for 6 this season.
Little delay here.
And here goes Letang. See if he comes with speed. Now he's going to try that slow approach. Now speeds up to the goal, and Elliott makes the save. Letang used to come with speed. He's been trying that different look where he kind of comes in with a lot of moves and kind of slows the pace, changes the speed. But Elliott wasn't buying what he was selling that time. And so it's time now for a defenseman to try. Kevin Shattenkirk of the Blues. Another defenseman.
Interesting.
Saw one for the Penguins, now one for the Blues.
Yeah.
Another delay. Shattenkirk approaching Marc-Andre Fleury, and Fleury with another save on the Blues defenseman. And it brings Evgeny Malkin to the table.
Now he's fun to watch. Fleury very patient here. Shattenkirk goes to the forehand. Fleury with the trapper making that save.
Gino has really gotten better on the shootouts. He's now 4 for 6 this year.
A lot of delays as they look to the penalty box. The gentleman standing there with the door open is telling them when they can go.
Malkin against Elliott. Shoots and scores!
Well, he picked a spot. He lifted his head. And he shot it right in the open side to the blocker. He's heads up all the way. Elliott, not a huge goaltender, Elliott. And when he backed up, Malkin had a lot of room there on the blocker side.
The Fleury stops Oshie. The Penguins win. And here comes Oshie at center. Another delay. And Oshie will approach Marc-Andre Fleury. Starts slowly, very slowly. Oshie in on goal, shoots it, he scores.
He came slow. Fleury threw a stick out right about here. And just a little flick shot. Just a little flick under the glove, over the pad.
And now James Neal again. He's been really good. He's 2 for 5, and he loves to start deep in his own zone. Everybody standing up as usual here in the building. And Neal coming ahead, looking to win it. Neal in on Elliott. Pitches the goal. Elliott stood up, and Neal missed the target. And we keep going.
And it gets interesting now as you look down your bench. Neal missing that high glove opportunity as Elliott there was on top of his crease when Neal released that puck.
Another defenseman.
Yep. I think what we're doing is waiting for the replays on the other telecast. The only thing I could figure. I've never seen a delay like this before each shooter. Unless they're waiting for TV. I'm not quite sure what that's all about, but here's Pietrangelo in on Fleury. Alex Pietrangelo, poke checked.
Well, Marc-Andre Fleury, as you say it, to Marc-Andre Fleury, had that stick out early. Pietrangelo, I thought he was going to go high glove. Instead, he tried to curl it around that poke check. And the Flower would have none of that.
So it's time for Kunitz in our Barrel.com shootout. See if he can send the Penguins home. Beating Elliott here in the shootout. Kunitz's numbers, 1 for 2 this year. He's pretty good in these situations. We saw him do it in Los Angeles. Here he comes against Elliott. shoots and scores! Chris Kunitz in his 500th NHL game wins it for the Penguins. Happy All-Star break, everybody. The Penguins have defeated the St. Louis Blues 3-2.